and welcome back our dear viewers. Today we'll be talking about the 145th anniversary of the inauguration of the old Suez Canal, which was inaugurated in 1869 during the time of Khedive Ismail. And also we are celebrating the passing of 100 days since the start of the work and digging for the new mega projects for the Suez Canal, which will be a major change and represent a major change for Egypt and the whole world. To shed more light on the issue, how this project is going on and what happened after 100 days, what are we expecting from this project, we are delighted to have our dear guest, Dr. Haysam Mamdouh, the head of Irrigation and Engineering and Hydraulics Department, Alexandria University. Hello, sir, and thank you for being with us.
A very good morning to you, doctor. Before we speak about the new Suez Canal project, the mega project that is being carried out in Egypt, let's go back in history. We are celebrating 145 years since the initial, or the first Suez Canal was dug. Let's talk a bit about the importance of the Suez Canal, not just for Egypt, but for the whole world trading order.
Yes, coming back to the 14th century, in times of Mamluk here in Egypt, it has been discovered the new route around Africa by the Portuguese, mm-hmm. and which affect Egypt in the international trade at that time. After that, in the era of Muhammad Ali, it has been introduced, this idea, by a French engineer, de Lesseps, in 1830, before the, it had been already in 1869, as you mentioned. But Muhammad Ali rejected that project because he thought that at that case, Egypt will be attacked by Western countries. So the project has been declared, started since 145 years ago. But Egypt doesn't benefit in the first until 1956, until the tripartite war. Mm-hmm. At that time, we have just benefited from 1956 for only 12 years until 1967, and after that again from 1975 to our current day. Mm-hmm. So I think this is a gift from Egypt to the international community, as this is considered as the hub of the communication between Asia and Europe. Mm-hmm. So it play an important role in the international trade, but we as an Egyptian, we didn't benefit a lot still, despite that we get a revenue of around 5.3 billion US dollar every year, but this is not considered as a high percentage of the international trade, because we didn't play until now, after 145 years, an international role in that international trade. So we hope by our declaration of new project that the economic situation will be completely different in the next 5 or 6 years. Mm-hmm.
What about the nationalization of the Suez Canal, which was done by late President Gamal Abdel Nasser? To what extent did that help Egypt benefit from the Suez Canal?
In Egyptian economy, we have got a huge benefit, because all the revenue at that time has been transferred directly to build the Aswan High Dam in 19, which has started in 1960 up to 1970. In addition to that, this is in our land, so we should just, because before that, Suez Canal is considered as a colonized from outside. So this is
in our soil.
In our soil. So this is, despite that it get assist us in our economy, but it has played an important role in our international in our trade budget every year, and it present now about I could not say maybe 20% of our international currency, which assists our economy. 5 billion US dollar every year are the revenue of that Suez Canal.
Right, doctor, back to modern day today. 100 days have passed since the beginning of the new Suez Canal mega project. It took 8 days to raise the funds needed from Egyptians at the time that they were needed. What progress have we done in the last 100 days? Do you think it's quick enough as expected and predicted, in your opinion?
Yes, it is really a big challenge for us, but coming back to collect 64 billion Egyptian pound in 8 days, it is considered as economical election for President Sisi. Mm-hmm. So I think this is, we have just in the 100 day I think that we have finalized almost the dry excavation, and now we start the dredging in the 70 kilometer using about 36 machines from Egypt and from outside, which has been declared yesterday during the meeting between President Sisi and Admiral Mohamed Mamish, the chairman of Suez Canal Authority. I am sure that this is a big challenge. I have a concern. I hope that, I am sure also that it could be terminated within 1 year. Let us, coming back to August 5th, when it has been declared that the initial proposal, it will be for 3 years.
Yes, and after that, it was just 1 year.
Just 1 year. And let us see the economic impact during this period. Because the Egyptian stock exchange market has reached today more than 9,000 points, which has been almost doubled. So if you compute this in terms of money, the Egyptian economy from the stock exchange has gained around 100 billion Egyptian pound in that period. In addition to that, before August 5th, we didn't have any company, the 60 company working today doesn't have any project before August 5th. And it has been estimated that there is the unemployability rate has been reduced. In addition to that, let us wait to the quarter report of our economic situation to see what is the exact growth in the economy for in that quarter.
Dr. Haysam, how do you evaluate the work done in the Suez Canal up to this moment, in the Suez Canal mega project up to this moment, after 100 days of work? And as you have just mentioned yesterday, that they have announced the sort of dredging operation, mega dredging operation taking place there.
Let us take about the dredging capacity of each dredger. It's about 2,000 meter cube per hour. If everything will work fine with those machines, we have just hired rent the most efficient machine in the world, five from Belgium, six from United Arab of Emirates, and another international company. According to the plan, we are now at the end of almost the middle of November. We could just expect this could be done until next August. Up to now, we are just on the plan for 1 year, but the big challenge will be the dredger, because the dredger is more need more technical issues than the dry excavation.
Why, sir?
Because the dredging, until you could, because let us look for the Suez Canal, the total depth is expected about 24 meter. You could dredge up to depths of 10 or 12 meter without a serious technical problem. When you going to
more depths,
it causes the excavation rate will be reduced. If you dredge 1 meter in the surface, not like 1 meter in the bottom.
Yes.
So about my experience in dredging, I say that we need more machine to finalize this plan in 1 year. But let us wait and see the work progress during the next 2 months to see our facilities working on Earth and to evaluate it again by end of January or the beginning of February.
Dr. Haysam, we all know the UAE is taking part in collaboration with Egypt during this period of work in the Suez Canal. The importance of such a collaboration, do you think it could speed up the process? And what are some of the challenges, in your opinion, aside from the technicality of the dredging issues? What other big markers are waiting, for example, in the digging of the new canal?
For digging, first of all, you have asked about the collaboration.
Indeed.
United Arab Emirates, we are collaborating together, and there is one of big companies there has already come with it about six dredger machine, and it stopped. And the UAE, United Arab Emirates, has quite a good experience in that
field.
So about the progress here in Egypt, I have heard one Yemen pilot of one of the dredger, he's talking, he's quite an experienced man from Yemen, in that machine. But about the challenge, just as we, it is a big project, which is the development of Suez Canal corridor. This is just one component out of the seven remaining components. We have seven other components, making a new Ismailia city, making a new industrial zone, making technological area evaluation, increasing the efficiency of the north port and the south port, and making fish farms, and making seven tunnels. So it is just one component, the new Suez Canal, out of several components. So we have a big challenge in the remaining issue. Just we want to clarify those projects for the economical forum, which will be held in South Sinai, as it has been declared yesterday. So what is very important at this stage is to make a concrete project or feasibility study or pre-feasibility study to present them to the investors who will come to invest in those six projects. So for me, from about the concerns, I have a concerns about some environmental impact, like the fish farms, which will be at the end of dredging pool in the Suez Canal. I have concern also about the water supply to this area, because I recommend that Ismailia Canal, which supply water to this area, should be rehabilitated or expanded, because we expect that about 5 or 7 million Egyptians will work there. So currently, the water supply to Ismailia and Suez is not enough. So we should include the Ismailia Canal rehabilitation work, and also making a navigation channel in Ismailia Canal between Ismailia Port and Cairo. So there is a new idea, quite a good idea, which should be involved in that project.
So to what extent also the mega project of the Suez Canal could help in increasing the level of trade and investment for Egypt?
Up to now, we didn't play any role in the international trade except just getting money from the ships.
According
to the fees, just. But this market is estimated about $80 billion US dollar between Asia and Europe. There is one big hub in Singapore and the other one in Rotterdam in Netherlands. You could just imagine, we have just Dutch Minister of Environmental and Infrastructure, Mrs. Schulz, has came here to Egypt. There is a big concern from Netherlands and from Singapore about that project. Why? Because we will take a part of this share, international share. So what is very important for us is to make the sorting of the containers inside our land. We have a quite a good, we will have a quite a good market if we just introduce this idea. So all boats coming from Asia and from Europe could be sorted inside this land and redistributed again accordingly. Like what happened exactly in Netherlands and in Singapore, and also Hong Kong plays like this role.
Revenue, the Egyptian economy is going to improve after the new Suez Canal is underway. Plus, of course, there will be a technological hub. This is going to make Egypt, and especially the area of the Suez Canal, very unique, this technological hub. How so, in your opinion?
About the technological hub, it has been also, it is under planning by the consultant and will be declared in February. But what has been declared till now is that there is, this project is 20, for it will be for 4 stages. Each stage involved some technological aspects and some technological field. I think that the Ministry of Telecommunication should be involved directly in that issue, besides the Ministry also of Industry. And we need just a clear portfolio of clear ideas to be presented in the next engineering forum. We have labor. Labor force in Egypt is available with quite a competitive prices according to the international one. So our market in Egypt, we are now 90 million. We could just play an important role, as you have mentioned, the technological hub or technological city, which will be in the eastern part of Ismailia. So let us wait and see until February or March, which this is one of the main components.
How can we use this project, the mega project of the Suez Canal, in order to market for this upcoming economic conference and to attract investors to come and invest in Egypt, which is of course the main target of inviting the leaders and inviting the investors to come for this conference, which will take place in March?
From a strategic point of view, the government should play just one important role, is to facilitate any problem which could outcome the investor coming. So like what happened in Singapore, this is the main role of the government, just to facilitate all issues and reduce taxes and encourage them to come to Egypt.
So creating more incentives.
Yes, to that issue, and to we have some problem in legal issues in Egypt. You should we need a new parliament just to issue new decrees and new laws, just to encourage foreign investors investors. Indeed. Because we have in that issue.
But then also, Doctor, what role in your opinion should be played by the Ministry of Investment? I mean, for any investor to come and just register their company, it's a lot of red tape, a lot of bureaucracy, a bit of corruption, as well as corruption. Corruption is an issue.
This, yes.
So what, in your opinion, needs to be done in order to create one-stop shops, one-stop windows, in order you register everything in just one stop without having to, it stretches out
for the
over a long time.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes, this is what should be declared during those days. Mm-hmm. Just any investor, when he came to Egypt, he just needs some issues. For example, we have issued a new decree in the renewable energy, but we have mixed the price in Egyptian pounds. The investor doesn't like this. They want to sell in foreign currency just to export the money. How could, if I make a benefit inside Egypt, I could transfer the money outside Egypt? This is the most critical question. Could we allow our Ministry of Investment could allow this or not? This is, should be clear. If I am a foreign investor and I came to Egypt and I make some profit and I want to transfer this money in a foreign currency, is it allowed in to Egypt or not? So this should be discussed. It could be for some percentage, 20%. So this is an issue. When he came to Egypt, how many Egyptians should work with him? Maybe 80% or 70%. So all this should be clarified in the one window.
One-stop shop.
One-stop shop. In addition to that, there is some field we should just prepare for them. Some issue about the supply of energy. We have an energy crisis in Egypt.
Yes.
We could, any investor will not come until we will solve this problem clearly, with clear plan, because any investor who will want to make a factory, he just want to be sure that he will not face an energy supply shortage. So we have big challenge in that field.
Doctor, what about the national benefits from the mega project? To what extent the people of Sinai, the people of the Suez, Ismailia areas could also benefit regarding the employment, regarding the benefits which could be reflected on them, especially Sinai?
As all the Egyptians know, we face a big war against terrorists. But it is not around Suez Canal, it is more than 150. In that case, the Sinai population is not more than 500,000. But they should work directly in all the jobs, get a high opportunity just to be selected to work in that in all the project to related to Suez Canal Corridor. And also the three Swiss governorate, like Bursaid and Ismailia and Suez. So they should consider that in the employability and also the qualification to get this work from those five governorate.
Indeed.
Okay. So I think that also that it could attract more than, as I mentioned, 5 or 6 million Egyptians to work in that area. Let us talk about the economic forum. This, the Suez Canal Corridor, is not the mega project, the only mega project. Until now, it has been, we have the Golden Triangle project, and Toshka project, and soon it will declare, I think, a new project in the western area, in the Tatara Depression. It is not clear if the economic forum we will present all those projects or only the project of Suez Canal. Until we discuss that maybe next time. But up to now, I think that what has been declared is only the Suez Canal Corridor project.
Right. Do you think, in your opinion, that there should be further discussions aside from the Suez Canal mega project during the conference to be held in Cairo?
A lot of
in Egypt, right?
Yes. We need, because there is some concerns about the other mega project from environmental impact and from the economic efficiency, like in that of Toshka expansion project, and also from the western coast in Qatar Depression, and generating electricity from a nuclear energy plant in Daba, and also a lot of concern because one of the project is to make a canal from the Mediterranean Sea to Qatar Depression to generate electricity. So there is a serious environmental concerns about that issue. But coming back to Suez Canal project, also I have a concern about the fish farm proposed by the Suez Canal Authority, because it will cause a big environmental problem in that area. Mm. In addition to that, it will not be economic because we need to pump water for an elevation for 7 meters and recirculate this and return back the water after treatment to the Suez Canal. Mm. So from my opinion, I have big concerns about the fish farms, which will be in the eastern part of the Ismailia Canal. Mm-hmm.
So how can we solve this issue? Could it be replaced? Could it be moved to other places? Or how can we overcome this
about
problem?
About fish farms? Yes. In fish farms, Egypt produces about 1.5 million tons every year. 90% are from fresh water, and the remaining are from salt water.
Yes.
So we have 7 lakes in Egypt. We could consider another place.
Yeah.
In addition to that, we have about 3,000 kilometers of lands on the coast, the Mediterranean coast and Red Sea. So Mediterranean Sea and Red Sea. So we could just evaluate the alternatives for that area, because the Swiss Canal Authority mentions that it will make the last 200 meters of the dredging pool. The dredging pool located on the eastern part is have about 5 kilometers width. So every 200 meters at the end will be for fish farms. I have big concerns about that.
What is your concern regarding that? Will it create a drop in the cycle?
No, environmental concerns and also economic issue. It will not be economical because we need to pump water for an elevation area of 7 meters. If you make a pipeline for 5 kilometers, you have a hydraulic losses and elevation of 7. So the pumping cost from the Suez Canal to those pools and recirculate it again, it will not make that project beneficial for that. So despite that of industrial zone and technological hub.
So what are your expectations regarding the timing in which we are going to witness the finish or the completion of work in this project?
When you are dealing with the Egyptian army, if the president mentioned 1 year, it will be 1 year. So I have
finished completely or the
yes,
first
yes,
phase.
Yes, yes, yes. It is a big challenge.
Yeah,
let's come
already
back.
100 days have
when
passed.
When he mentioned, president says that we want to collect 60 billion Egyptian pounds.
And we did.
And we did it
in
a
very short time.
Maybe 8 days, it's quite a long time.
It was amazing.
We don't know. Some people mentioned that it will not be collected, and others mentioned it will be collected in 1 day, and we have done it in 8 days. But about finishing that, be sure about that. I think that, and I hope from God that he could support the work, the engineering corps, the Egyptian army engineering corps, which is responsible mainly of that work. According to the strategic point of view of the new president, that any work done here should be under the supervision of Egyptian army.
Indeed.
Right. I'd like to thank you very much, Dr. Haysam Mamdouh, the head of the Irrigation Engineering and Hydraulics Department at Alexandria University. It's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you so much for coming in this morning.
Thank you very much, Dr. Haysam. And now we'll go to a short break, and after that we'll be back to resume the segments of the day.
لازم هنتحرك ونتحرك بقوة عشان نخرج من دائرة الفقر اللي احنا موجودين فيها. احنا بنسابق الزمن. احنا عايزين نبني بلدنا. عايزين نبقى في امل حقيقي. مش هنبيع وهم للناس. لان احنا متأخرين قوي. طب والله العظيم احنا مستعدين نبيع نفسينا عشان خاطر مصر. التخطيط اللي كان معمول قبل كده كان بيتصور ان احنا ممكن نتكلم على حاجة على امتداد القناة بالكامل. واحنا كان لينا في الدفاع وقتها، انا بقول وانا كنت مسؤول عن ده، وقلت ان ده هيبقى ضد الامن القومي المصري. في المشروعات اللي هي خاصة بالقناة وحفر القناة وملكية القناة دي للمصريين. زي دلوقتي لو كان ليا عمرنا، وإن شاء الله المصريين ليهم العمر، نيجي ونفتتح المرحلة ديت ونعبر في القناة الجديدة 35 كيلو.